I told you guys this update was right around the corner. And now today we have official confirmation from Rockstar, not only on the next DLC for GTA Online, but they are announcing that it is going to be the biggest DLC that we've ever seen for the game. And after the last two DLCs with the Casino Resort DLC and the Casino Heist DLC, I can't even think of how much better this could be because these last two updates were awesome. So I could not be more excited for this next update. On top of that, they've announced the next update for Red Dead Online. Let's jump straight to it. Let's take a look. So over on the Rockstar Games website, if you scroll down, we have this big GTA 5 picture with the announcement trailer for the extended and enhanced version, which makes me think they're already stepping up the ante before they release that. We come down to Newswire, and we've got this absolutely gorgeous picture of a leopard in Red Dead Redemption 2. Let's take a second to appreciate the detail on this animal because I absolutely love the wildlife in Red Dead Redemption. And when we scroll down, here we have July 24th, 2020, GTA Online and Red Dead Online updates coming soon. Go ahead and click on that and bring us to the actual newswire. Scrolling down, starting with the first paragraph here, Rockstar starts off by saying, "With both games playing home to more players than ever before in recent months, that is great news. The more people playing, the more top quality content we're gonna get. So good to hear." Continuing on, they say, "We know the community has been awaiting news of any updates for GTA Online and Red Dead Online." You got that right. "And we are happy to share that both games will receive exciting new updates in the weeks ahead." So in less than a month, we're going to have updates for both games. Excellent. Moving on, they say, "For Red Dead Online, players can expect a massive new update to arrive Tuesday, July 28th. So we are 4 days away from the Red Dead Online update, featuring a new frontier pursuit that will introduce players to the secrets of naturalism as part of an all-new role." Very good news. "Plus a new Outlaw Pass." For those of you not familiar with the Outlaw Pass, it is additional content that you can unlock by playing the game. I believe there's 100 levels that you can level up for the Outlaw Pass, where you can unlock outfits, clothing items, exclusive items for your horse, all kinds of cool stuff. So it really does give you something to strive for to unlock during the time frame of the Outlaw Pass. Moving on, Rockstar says, "Tons of community requested features and fixes and much more to play and discover in the months to come." Very exciting. And here we go. Here's what we've all been waiting for on this last paragraph, saying a summer update to GTA Online is also on the way, offering up a fun mix of diverse new content from the game's massive array of experiences to enjoy. Two things that stand out to me is the word fun and diverse. Sounds like a great mix because the Casino Heist was one of the funnest updates we've ever got to play with our friends. It has such a good variety of the prep work, things to do. When you do the heist, there's so many different ways to do it. So it actually blew past my expectations for that DLC. And let's take a closer look at this picture they released of a new supercar coming out for the update. The front end especially looks like a Jaguar, some kind of a Jaguar prototype supercar. Let us know down in the comments below if you have any idea, any guesses yourself to what car that is, or if you know, share it with us. That would be great. And just on the right of that, we have another picture of the wild outdoors in Red Dead Online. And it's really sounding to me like this is going to be more of a hunting role. It's looking that way with these photos, and I am really hoping we get some legendary animals like the grizzly bears. We saw that picture of the leopard that we can go out hunting for that are much more challenging and rewarding than all the animals in the game thus far. That would be amazing. And wait, there is more. As we scroll down here, we have one last paragraph below those two pictures where Rockstar says, later this year, players can expect more updates for both games, including some exciting new extensions and augmentations to an existing role in Red Dead Online, and the biggest ever update for GTA Online, featuring our latest take on heists in an entirely new location. My mind is blown right now. Where are we gonna go? Are we gonna go to Vice City? Are we going back to Liberty City? Are we gonna be doing some heisting in North Yankton in the snow with blizzards? This is so exciting. Oh my gosh, they are opening this game up and they are cracking it open. There have been speculation and rumors and fans begging and talking about, imagine if Rockstar opened up the map on GTA 5 and they added Liberty City and Vice City that we could travel between using airports. Not saying that's gonna happen, but regardless, a new location in addition to Los Santos, which we already have, has gotta be the most exciting thing Rockstar could have said. I am more excited than ever now for this next update. Let me know down in the comments what you guys think, if you have any guesses on this new location, where you think it might be, because we are finally getting a change of scenery in GTA Online. And to wrap things up, I'll share the community feedback that Rockstar shared with everyone on the bottom of the newswire, where they say, thanks to your submissions via our official feedback channels, we have added a number of highly requested features across recent updates, including musical instruments in Red Dead Online. That is awesome. If you guys have not checked that out, it is in the basement of the Moonshine Shack, and it is loads of fun. Moving on, they say the ability to run all businesses via the master control terminal in GTA Online, which I am doing right now as we speak for the double money for the MC businesses. And yes, guys, Rockstar is listening to us. They are listening to the fans. Sometimes Rockstar can go silent and go dark for months and months and months without saying anything, without letting anyone know what they're doing. People get frustrated, which is understandable, but Rockstar is hard at work. And I really think we're gonna see that with these next two updates from GTA and Red Dead Online. Moving on, Rockstar says, more of your suggestions will find their way into our games in the next few weeks. So please keep the feedback coming by sending us your thoughts via the GTA Online and Red Dead Online feedback pages. So if you guys do have any constructive criticism for Rockstar, definitely worth a few minutes of sending them a little message. And wrapping things up with the last paragraph, they say, we are also committed to ensuring that our games are fun for everyone and as safe as possible from modders, cheaters, hackers, and those who seek to harass other players. So far this year, we have taken action on hundreds of thousands of players caught violating community rules across both games. Please help us keep our communities safe and fun by reporting any sort of cheating, either directly in-game or via our dedicated web reporting tools for both Red Dead Online and GTA Online. And that is very good to hear as well, because the worst thing you can have is a broken game where you have somebody running around with God mode that you can't kill, or somebody manipulating your vehicles or your experience of the game. So well done, Rockstar. Hats off to you. And finally, they say on the last sentence that even more is on the way, so as always, stay tuned to the newswire for more information. And there we have it. Not only is the next DLC released, but we know it is going to be the biggest ever DLC that we've ever seen. So I imagine that your mind is going to be racing like mine, trying to figure this out, trying to think of what it is. The only thing I can say is we will never know. Nobody will know for sure. But judging from the last two DLCs, this one is gonna be good. So brace yourselves, get prepared. If you have any vehicles that you don't drive around anymore, sell them for some extra cash. And as I've been saying for the past 2-3 weeks now, save your money and now is the time to grind and take advantage of these double money business opportunities, because this DLC coming up, if it's going to be the biggest with a new location, you better believe it's going to be the most expensive. And while we don't have a definitive date for the release, we do know it will be less than a month, as Rockstar said, in the coming weeks. So it will be here before the last week of August, and we have the Red Dead Online update coming out in 4 days to tie us over. With all of that said, I could not be happier or more excited for this next update. Let me know down in the comments below what you guys think about what Rockstar has told us, if you have any predictions for the next DLC, and also if you'll be trying out the new update for Red Dead Online coming within the next few days. And if you guys will excuse me, it is back to the grind because I am going to need a lot of money for this next update. Until the next video, you guys stay cool, keep on playing GTA, and I will see you guys in the next video. H2TV, signing out.